Hello everyone, welcome to homeschool. So in this video we will take up the next part, that is the fruit. So we have completed the flower, the parts of the flower or the whorls of the flower in the previous video. So now we will take up with the fruit. So what exactly is a fruit? We have already seen that the ovary will develop into a fruit, or that will mature into a fruit after the fertilization, isn't it? So the fruit is the mature, it is a mature or the ripened ovary. Okay, the matured or the ripened ovary after the fertilization. After the fertilization will develop into a fruit. It will develop into a fruit. So a mature or the ripened ovary will develop into a fruit after the fertilization takes place. So for the fruit to be formed, the fertilization should take place. If the fruit is forming without the fertilization, alright. So, if the fruit is, for the fruit to be formed, fertilization is required. Sometimes there are chances that the fruits are also being formed without the process of the fertilization. Such fruits are called as the parthenocarpic fruits. That is, we will write it here. Parthenocarpic, P-A-R-T-H-E-N-O-C-A-R-P-I-C, parthenocarpic fruit. Very important, you have to remember this, parthenocarpic fruit. The fruit developed without fertilization. Fertilization is called as a parthenocarpic fruit. Alright, so now as we have seen that the ovary will develop into a fruit, or the ovary will change into a fruit, then we know that this is a ovary. This is a ovary, and ovary had ovary walls also, isn't it? So when the whole ovary is developing into the fruit, the ovary wall is also developing into a fruit wall. Okay, ovary is developed into fruit and ovary wall is developed into a fruit wall, and that fruit wall usually has three layers. The first or the outermost layer is called as the epicarp. The mid layer is called as the mesocarp. And the innermost layer is called as the endocarp. Okay. Ovary wall is changed into the fruit wall, which is called as pericarp. And this pericarp has got three layers, that is epicarp, mesocarp and the endocarp. So these are the three layers of the fruit wall. So if in neat exam they ask you which is the fruit wall among this, okay, if they ask which is the fruit wall among this, or the name of the fruit wall among this, and if they give you the options as pericarp, epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp, then you are supposed to choose the pericarp as the option, okay, because the fruit wall as a whole is pericarp only. These three, that is epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp, are the three layers of the pericarp. So alone the pericarp will not make the fruit wall. Alone the mesocarp will not make the fruit wall. Alone the endocarp will not make the fruit wall. It is the combination of all the three which is called as pericarp is the fruit wall. Okay, you should be very cautious about this. And then, so based on the nature of the fruit wall or based on the nature of these three walls of the pericarp, we can see few types of the fruits. So that is the simple fruits, aggregate fruits and the composite fruit. We will see one by one now. So first one, we'll first write the types of fruits. Types of fruits. Among them, the first one is the simple fruit. Simple fruit. So simple fruit, so this is mainly developed from the single ovary. The simple fruit is developed from single ovary. Okay, so we had seen that. So one single ovary is there might be chances that there might be many ovaries. So one single ovary developing into one single fruit is called as a simple fruit. And now in the simple fruit, again we have two variations. So that is, we will write it here. Simple fruit has got two variations. So one is a fleshy fruit, and then another one is a dry fruit. So this variation or this particular bifurcation of the fleshy fruit and dry fruit is mainly based on the nature of the pericarp. This is based on nature of pericarp. Okay, so fleshy and dry simple fruit. So example for the fleshy fruit is the tomato. It is tomatoes. And the example for the dry simple fruit is the apricot. It is apricot. So this is about the simple fruit which is developed from one single ovary. Then second one is aggregate fruit. Aggregate fruits. So here, in case of the aggregate fruits, so they are developed from the polycarpellary apocarpus pistil. Okay, we will write it first. Polycarpillary apocarpus pistil. What is a pistil? A pistil is nothing but a carpel. So the carpel structure, the one which we had seen, that is stigma, style and ovary. Stigma, style and ovary together, it was called as a carpel, and the same structure is also called as the pistil. Okay, so polycarpellary is many carpels together. We had seen one condition called as a single carpel, where it was called as monocarpellary. So if there are more carpels together present, then it is called as the polycarpellary. And we have also seen what is syncarpus and apocarpus. Syncarpus is a condition of free carpels, and apocarpus is a fused one. So many carpels which are fused together will make up one single fruit, and that fruit is called as an aggregate fruit. So if you have seen the custard apple, okay, example for this is custard apple. So if you see the custard apple, how it will be, or if you see the strawberry, how it is. So there are many, in the custard apple, we have many seeds together. Around every single seed, there is an edible pulp, isn't it? So edible pulp is actually the ovary there, okay, which has been turned into the ovule has turned into seed, and the ovary has been turned into the fruit there. So many carpels together like this. If this is a flower like this. So if you have, so these are all the carpels only. This is one carpel, two carpel, three carpel. So like this, bunch of carpels. Okay, bunch of carpels together will form a single fruit. That is the aggregate fruit. Then third one is the composite fruit. It is composite fruit. So in the composite fruit here, the whole inflorescence is developed into one single fruit. So you can also call it as multiple fruit actually. Multiple fruit. So if you have observed the jackfruit, or if you have observed the mulberry, pineapple. So if you, when you open the jackfruit, so inside that whole big jackfruit, you get to see many small fruits, isn't it? So that is one whole inflorescence is being developed into a single fruit. We'll write it complete in whole or whole inflorescence. Whole inflorescence is developed into a single fruit. Is developed into single fruit. So that is called as a composite fruit. So best example which we can quote here is the pineapple. Even in case of pineapple also, if you see it, it is like it has, you can easily make out actually jackfruit, pineapple, mulberry fruit. So jackfruit and pineapple to everyone have seen. So you can easily make out it is a composite or the multiple fruit. So these are the three types of the fruit. There is one more type of the fruit also, which is called as a drupe. So a small variation in this, actually it belongs to a simple fruit only. So if you have observed the coconut, or if you have observed the mango, so what happens in that case, like we have seen the fleshy simple fruit. In the simple fruit we had seen the fleshy and the dry fruit. So in case of fleshy fruit, what happens, the mesocarp, okay, sorry, the epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp, these are the three walls of the pericarp, or walls of the, or the, these are the three fruit walls. So here the mesocarp or the epicarp is very very thin, and mesocarp is usually fleshy, and the endocarp is acting like a central stone which contains the seed here. Okay, so we will write what is drupe, and then we'll get to know. The very important part which you have to remember here is the fleshy fruit which has got very thin skin and a central stone containing a seed is called as a drupe. Drupe. Alright. So here, as I said, the fleshy fruit, the flesh, we will take an example, we'll draw the diagrams and then we'll see it very clearly. Okay, the fleshy fruit with thin skin, the fleshy fruit with the thin skin and a central stone containing the seed and a central stone containing the seed is called as a drupe. And the most peculiar characteristics about these drupes are they usually develop from the monocarpellary superior ovaries. They develop from monocarpellary Carpellary. So we had also seen this is a simple fruit that it develops from one single ovary, isn't it? So one single ovary is nothing but one single carpel is present. So we are speaking about one single ovary, which is again the monocarpellary condition. So here also the drupe, which is also a type of the fleshy fruit in case of a simple fruit, also developed from the monocarpellary but superior ovaries. Okay, monocarpellary superior ovaries, but again they are single seeded in nature. So we will take a couple of examples so that we will understand it properly. So we will take two coconut, one example. Another example, we will take mango. I'm taking these two examples only because they're there in your NCERT. So you might expect a question that they might give you the diagram and they may ask you to label which part is what, or directly they can just give the edible part of the mango is, and edible part of the, or the fibrous part of the coconut is dash what. Okay, so I'm drawing these two diagrams only. So in case of coconut, what happens? So we will first to draw the diagram here. So this is okay, and all right, so we have just to drawn only half part of the coconut here, not the full one. So we have only drawn the half part here. Okay, so if you observe it properly, this part is actually the edible part. So this white part which is present, this white is all the edible part, and this is the hollow space wherein we see the coconut water present. Okay, so now this edible part, the white part which is present here, so this edible part is actually the seed. So here the edible part is the seed, this white part. Okay, we are speaking about the white part now. So about this part, this is all the brown part which we see. So here also we have one brown part, thick brown part surrounding the edible part. Edible part is held by the brown thick part, isn't it? So this thick part, that is the brown one. So this is actually the endocarp. This is the endocarp, and this edible part is the seed part. Okay, this is the seed part. This is the seed part. This is the endocarp. Now, after the endocarp, outside the endocarp, there should be a mesocarp. Where is the mesocarp? The fibrous part which is present here. Okay, the fibrous part which is present, that fibrous part is called as the mesocarp. Fibrous part is the mesocarp. Now, so if you see the whole coconut, okay, so if you see the whole coconut, the green part which we see outside, or after it ripens, it becomes brownish. The green part will become brownish. So that if you look into only that green part, that is very thin. Inside the green part, there is a fibrous part, hence we feel it is very hard. No, but actually that only that green part is very, very thin part, and that green part is actually the epicarp. So that epicarp, this fibrous mesocarp, and then we have this stony, okay, central stone, which is the endocarp. So we had written here the central stone containing the seed. So this is the central stone. Okay, this is a central stone which is containing the seed inside. So that central stone is nothing but the endocarp, which is containing the seed inside. It is called as a drupe here. Okay, and then this coconut water, which is present here, this is called as, many times it has been asked, many times in the examinations it has been asked. So that is called as a free nuclear endosperm. It is called as free nuclear endosperm. So now similarly, moving on to the mango here. So we will draw one mango now. Fine. Here also we have one peel off layer which is very very thin in nature, isn't it? That peel off layer which is very very thin, so that it can, that can be taken as epicarp. It can be taken as epicarp here. Now after the epicarp, we have edible part inside. So that fleshy part, that edible part, that is called as the mesocarp. It is called as mesocarp, and that is the fleshy edible part. And then after that, inside the fleshy edible part, we have one seed here. And to that seed, we have one layer which is called as endocarp. So this endocarp is again the central stone. Okay, endocarp is a central stone which is containing the seed inside. Okay, so we call this also as the drupe. So here this can be taken as a seed, and the layer of that is the endocarp. Fine. So any fruit which is bearing the like the outer part is very very thin, is having very thin skin, and the central stone part which is containing the seed and which is developing from the monocarpellary superior ovary, which is again superior in nature, and it should have only one single seed. Here also there is one single seed, here also there is one single seed. Okay, so such fruits are being called as the drupes. So there is nothing much about the fruits actually. So all that you have to study here is the types of the fruits. So that is, we have already seen the simple fruit, the aggregate fruit, and the composite or the multiple fruit. And one variation which you have to remember in the simple fruit or simple fleshy fruit is the drupe here. Fine. So this completes the fruit. So in the next video we will come up with the seed. Okay, so this is very simple topic, and there shouldn't be any confusions about the fruit. And in case if they ask you any questions about it, so that would be definitely on the walls, or they can be usually on the drupes. Of course they can also ask about the types of the fruits, you never know, but still remember what exactly, especially these two examples which are given in your NCERT, they are very important. Many a times the questions have been repeated on these two diagrams or these two examples especially. Okay, so study properly, and I'll meet you guys in the next video with the seed.